Thank you. Dear Chairman, dear Justices, distinguished guests from all over the world present here or participating via the internet. As Chairman of the Swedish Judges Association, it's a pleasure and honor for me to welcome you here to Stockholm, Sweden, and the Symposium on Judges on the Environment, which is held in conjunction with the UN Stockholm+50 conference. Given the subject of the symposium, I believe it would be appropriate as an introduction to mention the reference to the late Professor Staffan Westerlund, Sweden's first professor in environmental law. He often discussed the connection between the different actions available for society to achieve a clean and healthy environment and the overriding goal of sustainable development. He illustrated this with three examples. The first is the heart, you know, the moral compass. Through information and education, you may reach far to inspire people towards environmentally friendly behavior and sustainable way of living. Unwanted behavior that cannot be stopped by the heart may instead be reached by the second example, the dollars. By this, you refer to economic instruments, which would contain different systems of subsidies, taxes, or fees, implemented with the purpose of influencing and steering actions and activities in a sustainable direction. By the end, the final example is the law. How it's constructed, interpreted, applied, and executed. Here, of course, the judiciary is recognized as having a vital role. And in a global context, courts and judges have been appointed as key players. Regional, national, and global symposiums for judges have been held during the years. Knowledge, ideas, experiences have been exchanged, strengthening awareness of common issues and how environmental matters can be addressed by the courts. 50 years have now passed since the Stockholm Environmental Conference of 1972, which in a way was a starting point for much of the global cooperation on and the development of environmental law. The Stockholm Declaration, along with the Rio Declaration for 92, are documents that remain crucial for these ongoing efforts to improve and develop ideas and goals for the future. Networks of judges exist in many countries, and efforts have been made in resolve the issue of how to take care of environmental matters via the courts. In Sweden in 1999, for example, 5 specialized environmental courts were established, as well as a specialized appeals court. The jurisdiction of these courts now cover most issues related to health, the environmental planning and building, and also land disputes. Environmental problems are often of a global nature, and the same principles of environmental law are applied by courts all over the world. This symposium will be of great importance for the future, and I hope that you will find it a great opportunity to share your experiences, be inspired by some of the speeches at the symposium, and start discussion with judges from other countries. Unfortunately, I won't be able to be here for the whole symposium, but I hope you will have 2 fruitful days here in Stockholm. You're so welcome. Thank you.